Hello and welcome to ThePapare.com, Sri Lanka's number one sports hub. Today we have a very special guest, one of the hardest hitters of the cricket ball, Ramith Rambukwella. Ramith, welcome to the show.
Good morning.
First of all, we would like to start off with the recently concluded mercantile cricket tournament, the T20 tournament especially. You scored 252 runs in just four matches. Do you want to start by touching on that?
Well, first of all, I'm very glad that I got a chance to open the batting, which is where my real strength is. Though I was branded as a middle order hard hitter, all my strength throughout my career has been as an opening batsman throughout the under-19s and my school level. All the big centuries I scored as an opening batsman, and finally got the chance to go there as an opening batsman and show what I can do.
You told about your career where you were as a middle order batsman. So would you like to start upon how you started the passion for cricket, how you started playing cricket?
Yes, ever since I was a kid, I've always watched cricket matches with the great Arjunas, the Aravindas playing. I never missed a match. I used to sit with my father and watch every single game. And actually, the great Arjuna Ranatunga is the one who visited my house one day and saw me and then convinced my father actually to put me to a cricket academy. And I started my career at NCC School of Cricket with the great Lionel Mendes. And starting from there, throughout college, starting from grade 6, I represented under 11 and, all the stages in college as well.
Yeah, so playing for Royal College, the best thing for Royal College is the Roy Toe Big Match. So you played three Roy Toe Big Matches. What's your best memory of Roy Toe and your experience?
Well, that would be my second year, the second big match I played. I got 165. It was definitely one of the highlights of my career as a schoolboy cricketer, which I cherish every day. It was a very good experience. I mean, playing that crowd, that atmosphere was just absolutely phenomenal.
So after school, how did you make that next level to the club cricket and to the national level?
Well, the year I scored that 165, I also got 1,000 for college, which automatically got me into the under-19 Sri Lanka pool, where I toured England. And yes, throughout I was opening bat as well. And I represented the under-19s, and after that, club cricket, under-23s, starting at SSC and followed by CCC. I played for a couple of clubs, and then I've established myself at Tamil Union now.
Yes, so we are having the next domestic season coming up. You're playing for Tamil Union. What's your target? Playing for Tamil Union, will you be opening the batting or just playing as a middle order batsman?
Like I said, all throughout my career, I've scored as an opening batsman. I mean, the way I got into the middle order was, at the time, for me to come into the Sri Lankan side was as an off spinner, and I neglected my batting and I worked hard on my bowling just to get a chance in the national team. But that was a big mistake, and now I think I've made the right decision and I'm going to open this season, and hopefully it will work well for me.
You have played only two T20 matches for Sri Lanka. So where do you think you fell off the grid after just playing two matches?
Again, the two games I played, I didn't do bad. I mean, my debut, I bowled my four overs. I played as an off spinner. Bowled my four overs for 19 runs with one wicket. And the last game I played was last summer in England, where also I scored 19 and couldn't bowl because that game we lost. So after that, I came back and then I was just out of the squad. But still, I've represented about 7 or 8 team tours. Fairly performed well, so still hanging in there, fighting for a place.
Yes, so what do you think you should be doing in order to make a comeback to the national team?
Definitely, I have to work on my fitness and say batting. I really want to concentrate and prove a point and just show that I am an opening batsman. Every big score I've got is as an opener, all my hundreds, everything. So I think the best way for me to come back into the scene is definitely as an opening batsman, looking at the 50 overs and the T20s mainly, because I feel I can do more damage within the power play overs as an opening batsman, because my strength is hitting the ball hard and I can hit the ball hard. So I think the opening slot is ideal for me, and I'm going to work hard towards it this season.
Yes, and another thing is, you're a politician's son. So does that give you extra bit of pressure in your performances and how people take you as a cricketer?
Yes, unfortunately, Sri Lanka is a very judgmental country, so you have to be very careful. And you're always in the limelight when you're somebody. So yes, it does affect me. There is pressure, there is media pressure, there's a lot of pressure. But I mean, end of the day, I'll just let the bat do the talking. If I have the runs to back me up, there shouldn't be any problem.
Yes, and next month there's another interesting tournament, the T10 Cricket League in Dubai. You'll be representing Team Sri Lanka Cricket. So what's your plans on that? Would you want to make a statement during that tournament as well?
It's very interesting because, I mean, within professional cricket, I think that's going to be, like, ICC approved, the shortest format. Should be interesting and 10 overs a piece. So, I don't know, it's a challenge because you have to get runs and also you have to contain the batsman as well. So it'll definitely be something new for everybody and hopefully it'll be a fun tournament.
Yes, and you stressed upon the fact that you want to concentrate on batting as a opening batsman. So does that mean you'll be just giving up on bowling off spinners?
No, definitely not, because I think to represent Sri Lanka, being all round is very crucial. Because even though you fail with the bat, you have a chance to do something else once you get out there. So being all-round is very crucial and I'm definitely not giving up on my bowling. Because, I mean, we have a lack of off-spinners as well in the Sri Lanka team currently. So I'm definitely going to work as an all-rounder, a genuine all-rounder. But mainly as an opening batsman, because that is my strength, as I believe.
Yes, and another question, one simple one. A part of playing cricket, what are your like hobbies, what do you do during your leisure?
Well, I am actually a stay-home kind of guy and I enjoy my free time watching movies. Obviously, I'm married now, so I just like watching movies and traveling.
All the fans watching this will obviously would want to make a point saying Ramith Rambukwella will be making a comeback into the national team as an opening batsman. Thank you, Ramith, for joining us with ThePapare.com.
So,
we wish you all the very best
for
a great career ahead, and we will be there with you all the time.
Thank you.